Hello everyone. In today's podcast, we're going to talk a few pointers about vulva intraepithelial neoplasia or VIN. Considering the premalignant lesions of the vulva, there are three which you need to remember, that is VIN, Bowen's disease and Paget's disease. Initially, the VIN was classified as VIN1, VIN2 and VIN3 depending upon the thickness of the skin and epidermis involved. Then in 2004, a new classification of VIN came up where it was divided into usual VIN, that is UVIN, which was a HPV-dependent lesion occurred more in the younger age group and was a multifocal disease. Another type was the differentiated VIN, which was HPV-independent, was more related to chronic inflammatory diseases like lichen sclerosis. It occurred in postmenopausal women, constituted only about 20% of the lesions and presented with epidermal thickening. And the last classification in the 2004 classification was VIN unclassified. Any lesions which did not come under the usual VIN or the DVIN was classified as unclassified VIN. In 2015, again this classification was changed, and now the new terminology used is ELSIL, HETSIL and VIN differentiated. The risk factors for VIN include which are similar to that of cervical intraepithelial neoplasia, like multiple sexual partners, early age at first coitus, immune suppressive conditions, multiparity, smoking, and prior history of CA cervix or CIN. These patients usually are asymptomatic and these findings are incidental, but some of them present with pruritus vulva, pain in the region, burning sensation, or you can find it on an abnormal cervical cytology, that is abnormal pap smear, but there is no lesions on the cervix or the vagina. So on examination, these findings can be confirmed using the acetic acid test, where you use a 5% acetic acid solution and look for acetovite areas after 3 minutes. And one more is the Collins test, where you apply 1% of toluidine blue solution and look for abnormal areas. Confirmation of the disease is done by biopsy, where you use a key sponge biopsy or a knife biopsy. Once the diagnosis is confirmed, the treatment options depend upon whether it is ELSIL or HETSIL. ELSIL lesions, mainly you can observe and repeat the test after a few weeks, whereas HETSIL lesions, they need to be treated because they have higher chances of going into vulvar CA. The most common treatment option for HETSIL lesions will be a wide local excision, where you spend the specimen for HPR with a 1 cm negative margin, but problems associated with it are a lot of pain, scarring and recurrence rate of 20%. Other treatment options include CO2 laser ablation, but in this procedure you don't have any specimen to send for HPR and it's a slow, painful healing process. Topical medications include 5-fluorouracil local application or the immune modulator imiquimod, which needs to be applied locally for 16 weeks. But this topical application causes a lot of burning sensation, desquamation of skin, pain and a lot of recurrence rate. Newer modalities include cavitational ultrasonic surgical aspiration, that is CUSA, which can be used on non-hair-bearing areas, cause less pain and scarring, but you can send a surgical specimen for HPR, which is fragmented in nature. Considering other pre-malignant vulval lesions include the Paget's disease and the Bowen's disease. Paget's disease has a similar manifestation like that of Paget's disease of the breast. Basically, it is the external manifestation of the underlying malignancy. Usually, underlying adenocarcinoma of the apocrine glands of the skin are involved, and typically they present with weeping eczematous lesions. Paget cells demonstration in the biopsy is diagnostic, and management include a wide local excision, vulvectomy or Mohs micrographic surgery if there is no underlying malignancy. If there is an underlying malignancy found, then do a radical vulvectomy with inguinal femoral lymph node dissection. Bowen's disease mainly presents with indurated patch. You demonstrate Bowen's cells or prickle cells on biopsy and the treatment includes vulvectomy. Hope it was useful. Thank you for listening. Keep listening and keep subscribing. Thank you.